They're trying to solve a really difficult, very difficult problem.
So the problem that Allegheny County faced was that we get a lot of calls to the child welfare hotline every year, so about 15,000 calls. We have limited information on which to make a screen in, screen out decision, decide which of those cases to go and investigate. And we thought we could use the data that we already collect to support decision making on the front line.
So the Allegheny Family Screening Tool at the broadest level is a forecasting tool. It tries to give an idea to a frontline worker, given the background history of this family, what the chances are that this child will be removed from home. The methodology we use to create the algorithm, in very simple terms, is we do a statistical technique called data mining, where we're basically looking through millions of patterns in the data, in historical data, seeing how it correlates to outcomes, and then matching each new case with those patterns that we've seen in the previous data.
Well, data is still the driving force, and as we go forward, it's going to be more and more important. The predictive analytics work is unique, and it's the first time we've gone down this path. And we're actually trailblazers in the United States in doing this.
So when we first saw the call for proposals, we were really excited because this is something that we've done in theory as researchers. But what Allegheny offered us was the opportunity to partner with a really outstanding agency where leadership, data, and frontline culture is fantastic.
I would say it was definitely an integrated partnership. Researchers providing feedback to us, practitioners providing feedback to the model. And remains integrated today. We're still looking at data, tweaking the model. It's been a really strong partnership.
The taxpayers pay our salaries, and they expect excellence. They expect the best possible service, and they expect us to keep children as safe as possible and to keep them protected and out of harm's way. This tool enables us to do a better job with that.
No one thinks that our child welfare system is making perfect, unbiased decisions now. We know that racial disparities, class disparities, and unevenness across workers is present. And so the question is, on the margin, can tools such as what's been developed in Allegheny County help to improve and standardize practice and hopefully make it less biased as well?
People are used to researchers like us sitting in our office, doing our data crunching, writing papers. This is very different. I've had to go out to communities, including the folks in the child welfare system, users, people who will be the people that our model will be used with, and explain to them in very simple terms and in very accessible ways what we're trying to do. So I think that's been the challenge, but that's been the pleasure for my research group.